What's going on, wrestling fans? I got a request to do my wrestling collection. I thought that would be really fun to do, kind of change it up a little bit. And I was talking about my passion with horror films and, of course, heavy metal. And I have another passion, too, and it's old school pro wrestling. I can't stress that enough, old school pro wrestling. I'm not really the biggest fan of wrestling these days. Definitely a fan of the Undertaker, Austin era, Attitude era. I remember, you know, being a fan of the Monday Night Wars. That was just a great time to be a wrestling fan. I grew up with that. And, of course, way before that as well. Just a huge fan. So I'm going to show some of my wrestling video collection. That should be a lot of fun. And talk a little bit about my favorite matches and moments. So, let's get into this. And these are going to be no particular order whatsoever. It's kind of just like whatever I grab, really. Alright, let's go. First up, we have No Way Out from 1998. Any match with Austin always stands out, but for me, it's probably Vader versus Kane with Paul Bearer. That one was badass. 98 was such a great year. 99 was a great year too. And we have Fully Loaded, 1999. First Blood, End of an Era match. Obviously, that's the one that sticks out for me. Fully Loaded strap match with Triple H and Rock was a really good one too. This was a really good pay-per-view. But yeah, definitely Undertaker versus Austin. First Blood, End of an Era match. Vince has to leave. Obviously, that never happened, right? But badass. I remember watching that one on pay-per-view. A lot of these I actually watch live on pay-per-view. Just such nostalgia, you know? If you're an old-school wrestling fan. Yeah, Royal Rumble from 1999. 1999 was also an amazing year. Definitely Austin and the Royal Rumble, but I would have to say I Quit match between Mankind and The Rock. That one always stands out. Such a brutal match. Love that. I have Rock Bottom from 1998. Definitely the match that stands out here is the Buried Alive match between Undertaker and Stone Cold. That one always stands out. Remember watching that one live as well. Such great moments. This is going to be so much fun, like, talking about some of this shit, you know? Ground Zero from 1997. 97 was such an amazing, phenomenal year for wrestling. So much happened. But yeah, I definitely would have to say that Taker versus Shawn Michaels. I think this was their first ever meeting, wasn't it? Yeah, I think this was actually their first ever meeting. Badass. Yeah, Fully Loaded 2000. Remember watching this one live too with some friends. Obviously, Undertaker versus Kurt Angle, that was good. The Last Man Standing match between Triple H and Jericho, that was a really damn good one. And of course, The Rock versus the late Chris Benoit, that one was a very brutal match as well. That was a really good pay-per-view, Fully Loaded 2000. Remember seeing this one live as well. That was King of the Ring 2001, I'm sorry. Yeah, I did see this one. Triple threat match for the WWF Championship. Stone Cold, Jericho, and Benoit. That was amazing. Undertaker confronts Diamond Dallas Page. That was a whole stalker angle. King of the Ring, that was cool. The video that Vince doesn't want you to watch, Hitman Hart Wrestling with Shadows. Such a great documentary on what a douchebag Vince really can be. Yeah, this is a great one. It's tragic that Goldberg ended Bret Hart's career, because he was such a legend. Maximum Impact. This is also known as Canadian Stampede. Remember seeing this one as well. Undertaker versus Vader, how it stands out. But of course, the Hart Foundation versus Austin, Legion of Doom, Goldust, and Ken Shamrock. That was cool too. Now we have an Undertaker documentary. This is My Yard. This is his American Badass days. It's My Yard. I remember that. Cool documentary. He doesn't want you to know that documentary though, because Sarah, his ex-wife, is on there, so that's kind of like a big no-no. This one's actually taped, but it goes for ridiculous prices, but this is when Taker won the title from Hogan. That's Judgment Day 2002, that's actually taped from the pay-per-view. Not a very good match, but it's cool to see Austin, or Taker, get the title again. 99 was a great year. No Mercy, 1999. The return, Stone Cold versus Triple H, after Triple H beat the shit out of Austin's legs at SummerSlam. Very great match. Absolutely love that one. Oh yeah, the Terry Invitational Tournament, the greatest ladder match in history. Hardy Boys versus Edge and Christian, that was the beginning of that whole feud. That was awesome. You got WrestleFest 97, Revenge of the Taker. Undertaker versus Mankind for the championship. That one was always great. Always a great meeting between Austin and Bret the Hitman Hart. Never gets old. God, I miss those days. This is when wrestling was at its peak. Just, I love this shit so much. Love going back and rewatching all these classic moments. At WrestleMania 14, this is the where Austin wins the title for the first time and the Stone Cold era begins. Obviously, Undertaker, Kane meeting for the first time, I was stands out as well. That was a badass one. WrestleMania 13, Taker gets the title from Psycho Sid. But obviously, the match that stands out here is that submission match between Austin and Bret Hart. That was just a amazing fucking match. Absolutely unreal. It pushed so many buttons and just created so many great moments. And the Austin pretty much turned into an anti-hero after that match, and Bret Hart was the heel. Got Rampage 97, Bad Blood. Oh, yeah. The match that stands out here, that's kind of self-explanatory. That's definitely the first ever Hell in a Cell match between Undertaker and Shawn Michaels. That's just amazing. Rest in peace, Brian Pillman. He didn't die at this pay-per-view, but they announced his death on it. It's kind of sad. He was scheduled for a match. I forget with who, though. We got SummerSlam 97. This is one of my favorites too. I always loved that cover. I would have loved to have gotten a poster of that back in the day. Heart and Soul. US versus Canada, basically. Undertaker versus Bret Hart. Championship match. Oh god. Yeah, this is where Austin gets almost paralyzed by the late great Owen Hart. Yeah, how could we ever forget that? Intercontinental title match. Holy shit, that was nasty, man. Nasty bump. But Shawn Michaels beating the shit out of Bret Hart with the chair, or hitting The Undertaker with the chair, costing him the title. Of course, that would start their whole feud in 97. This one's a bit beat up, but I always loved this one. King of the Ring 99. Rock versus Undertaker. And then Stone Cold versus the McMahons. Such a great pay-per-view. We've got a couple more. Let's see. We got No Way Out from 2000. Definitely the match that stands out is Mick Foley's retirement match, even though he did come back technically at WrestleMania 2000. But he always says that this is pretty much his retirement match, even though he did come back and fight Edge at WrestleMania. Then he came back to help The Rock too, but still, officially, this is pretty much his closing curtain as far as he's concerned. Triple H put him out of the business. Cactus Jack, Hell in a Cell match, amazing. That one all stands out. Definitely Chris Jericho versus Kurt Angle, Intercontinental title match. That was a great one as well. Sexual Chocolate versus Viscera. Oh, these were the days. let's see. Oh, yeah. Hell yeah! Damn right. Awesome documentary. I believe this is the third Austin video. First one was because Stone Cold said so, and then Austin 316 Uncensored, and then Hell Yeah. Badass. It's cool to see the friendship between him and Jim Ross. Let's see, you got Backlash. What one is this? 2002, yeah. Yeah, this is Hogan versus Triple H. Yeah, that was a cool fucking match, actually. Stone Cold versus Undertaker, number one contender match. That's right, Ric Flair was the hit part owner back then. That was cool. That was a cool angle. Backlash. All right, hold on. I'm gonna change something real quick. Sorry about that. If you watch me this long, you know I don't believe in editing. I just kind of put out whatever. Very not professional videos, I know, but whatever. It is what it is. And we have Royal Rumble 2002, taped from the pay-per-view. Sorry, Vince. I know it's illegal. Oh, this is Backlash. What is this one? Is this 99? Yeah, Backlash 99. This was a badass, very underrated Undertaker versus Ken Shamrock match. I love that match. Undertaker's not... Mark Calloway never really does a lot of submission matches back then, and that really was kind of new territory for him. And I always thought that that Ken Shamrock Undertaker match was really underrated. And you don't hear from it. I mean, you can watch it, but, you know, they don't really... They kind of erased Ken Shamrock, I guess, is what I'm trying to say. But it was a good match. And obviously, Rock versus Austin, the return match from WrestleMania. In fact, I think that's even better than the WrestleMania match they had. I think Shane McMahon was the referee. You got some brutal shit here. King of the Death match. My God. Cactus Jack pretty much made this famous. Mick Foley. Very brutal shit. This is definitely not WWF. Crazy Japan hardcore shit. I'm a whole huge fan of all that as well. Love crazier the better. Even got ICP Stranglemania. That's fucking crazy. Let's see. We have... Oh boy. Oh! Hexshot Jim Duggan. I skip around in years, that's for sure, when it comes to wrestling. SummerSlam 98. This is actually one of my favorite pay-per-views of all time. I love that match between Austin and Taker at Madison Square Garden. They just lit the fucking place on fire for sure. Such a great match. Triple H versus Rock. That was an amazing Intercontinental Championship ladder match. This was a great pay-per-view, SummerSlam 98. The Highway to Hell. I think that's what it was billed as. Got Royal Rumble 96. This is when Taker had to wear that creepy mask because I think Mabel broke his nose or something. I think that's what happened. Ahmed Johnson, nobody likes him. Razor Ramon, rest in peace. Oh man, yeah. It was a good Rumble, but definitely Bret versus Taker. That stands out. Here's another WrestleMania 13, but this is the Coliseum video release. I always prefer the Coliseum video releases. Really badass. The feud of the century right there. Austin versus McMahon. I watched that so much growing up that I wore it out. So much great memories. SummerSlam 95. Who does Taker fight? Oh yeah, he fights Kama, that's right. Bob Sparkplug Holly versus Hunter Hearst Helmsley. But Shawn Michaels versus Razor for the Intercontinental Ladder match. That one stands out for me. I haven't dug these Coliseum videos out in so long. They're so dusty. King of the Ring 97. I think Taker versus Farouk in this one. Yeah. Championship match with Farouk. Badass. Definitely anything with Austin. Last Man Standing. Shawn Michaels. Those are just so nostalgic for me. It's Our Time. This is actually getting pretty damn rare to find, of course, because the whole China thing, you know? They pretty much just... I don't know, I don't like how they treated her. But that's another video. Her contributions to the women's division, though, is just unmatched, in my opinion. The Ninth Wonder of the World, rest in peace. No Way Out. What is this one? Is this 2000? Oh yeah, 2001. Oh shit, yeah. This is a 2 out of 3 falls match. Austin and Triple H. First fall, one-on-one. Second fall, street fight. That's fucking brutal. And third fall, cage match. Wow, yeah. That was an amazing match. Jericho, Benoit, X-Pac, and Eddie Guerrero. Remember that one, Lincoln? I was badass. Here's WrestleMania 12 on Coliseum Video. The Return of the Ultimate Warrior. He fought Hunter Hearst Helmsley. He just kind of wants to forget that match, I know. But Diesel versus Taker. But you got to say the Iron Man match between HBK and Brett. Just unbelievable. Really pushed the boundaries for what wrestling could be. That match definitely changed the game as far as I'm concerned. Best of Raw Volume 2. Such great moments. Oh, we're really going old school here. Holy shit. Survivor Series 1999. This is the debut of the Gobbledygooker. Yeah, the Gobbledygooker. For sure. No shit. And that is the Dream Team versus the Million Dollar Team, and that is the debut of Mark Calloway, The Undertaker. Always holds a special place in my heart, for sure. But Gene Okerlund dancing with the Gobbledygooker, that's a wrestling moment. Some more old school, holy shit. Survivor Series 1991. Hulk Hogan versus Undertaker, championship match in Detroit. Taker gets the title because Ric Flair puts a chair out and then Taker tombstones Hogan and knocks him out, supposedly. This was a badass pay-per-view. I love these old ones. So much fun. I like these big boxes of Coliseum video. I imagine these probably go for quite a bit if they're in good condition. Sid Justice versus Hogan. Macho Man Flair, that always stands out. Undertaker versus Jake the Snake Roberts. I was one of my favorites. But a really good underrated match, I think, is Roddy Piper, the late great Roddy Piper versus Bret Hart Intercontinental title match, where he's going to hit him with the bell. Yeah, that's a great moment. All this shit's starting to come back to me. This is cool. WrestleMania, was that 7? Yeah, my Roman numerals are not the best. Yep, definitely Sergeant Slaughter versus Hogan. Taker versus, where the hell do you fight? Oh yeah, Jimmy Superfly Snuka, that's right. This is his debut WrestleMania. That's cool. Keep forgetting he came in 7. That's right. That's some more old school. SummerSlam 94. Bret Hart, cage match, sibling rivalry. That was such a great angle. Such a great match. I absolutely love that. But, of course, you guys say Undertaker versus Undertaker, who I believe the fake Undertaker is Chains of DOA, and also a good friend of Mark Calloway's, biker buddy. But that was cool, Undertaker versus Undertaker, and then Leslie Nielsen's there, and George Kennedy are trying to solve the case. That was just fun. Survivor Series 87 and 97. Really great moments. I thought the Survivor Series was cool. I don't even know if they do Survivor Series anymore. I don't even know what they do in wrestling anymore because I really don't even watch it. Royal Rumble 94. 94 and 93 really weren't the best years for the WWF because of the whole steroid lawsuit that Vince was going through and all that. But Taker versus Yokozuna, rest in peace, casket match, that was cool. I like how the fucking smoke and shit comes out of the coffin at the end. That was really awesome. Stone Cold Steve Austin. What? One of my favorites. They still do that damn what chant, man. That's crazy. This is from 2001 and they still do it in 2023. I saw The Undertaker get inducted in the Hall of Fame and they're doing the what thing to Vince. That was fucking cool. Kind of gets annoying after a while, though. Unforgiven 98. God. How can I not say the Inferno match? Jesus H. Christ. First ever Inferno match, Undertaker and Kane. That's just... It's only the second time they met, and that's the best, man. I absolutely love it. I still can't believe they did that, an Inferno match. Even Mark Calloway, when they talked to him about that, he's just like, that was just off the page. And an Austin versus Dude Love, where he hits Vince with a chair, that just sparked that whole feud, too. Definitely great. What the hell is this? Something from Movie Gallery. Oh, St. Valentine's Day Massacre, 99. Yep, cage match between Vince and Austin. Very cool. Really going old school here. Hulkamania 4. Hogan's the man. Changed the face of wrestling forever. Much respect. Probably wasn't the greatest worker in the business, but definitely put a lot of asses in seats, you know? Austin 316 Uncensored. This is one of my favorites. Oh, hello, man. Fuck yeah. When he's showing Jim Ross how to do the stunner, that's great. That's some good moments. We have three faces of Foley, Mick Foley, Dude Love, Cactus Jack, and Mankind. Man, so much respect for Mick Foley. You'll be seeing a lot more of him in these videos for sure. Got World Tour 92. I forget what's all on here. Bret Hart versus Rick Martel. Okay. Undertaker's got to be on here somewhere, I imagine. Macho Man, rest in peace. Invasion of the Body Slammers. Badass. I think Undertaker versus Razor Ramon. That's a rare match. And Papa Shango. Mr. Perfect versus Ric Flair. That is a great match. God, those are two of the most amazing wrestlers. I respect the art of wrestling, you know. Really good athleticism. Along with brutality. Super Tape 4. This is, Undertaker versus Tugboat. Oh, that was a horrible match. But, yeah, whatever. It is what it is. He didn't always have the greatest opponents to work with. In the beginning, you know. Undertaker the Phenom. Awesome video. I wore this one out, too, growing up. one of my absolute favorites. So much respect for Mark Calloway and his contributions to what he's done in wrestling. This is one of my favorites. This is the Classic 5 of 98. I'm not going to take that out, but we have the Royal Rumble, SummerSlam, Survivor Series, King of the Ring. Oh my god, I got to talk about King of the Ring a little bit. Obviously, the one that stands out on that is the Hell in a Cell match, Mankind Taker. That's just one of the most insane matches still to this day that they've ever pulled off. Put so many asses in seats, made a lot of money, but really pretty much started the decline of Mick Foley's career. You know, he really, really got hurt. You read his book, Have a Nice Day. He talks a lot about that match and those moments. Such amazing career for Mick Foley and Undertaker. 98 was my favorite year. It was so fun, like, being a fan of the Monday Night War, just channel surfing, you know, going from WWF to WCW, you know, to even ECW. It was just such a great moment to be a wrestling fan. I would never trade that shit for the world. It was just so much fun. And you go to school the next day and you talk to your friends who are also in wrestling, into wrestling, about, did you see what happened last night, you know? And yeah, it was just so much fun. And lastly, I have Insane Clown Posse's Stranglemania. This is actually like the King of the Death match. I know Jay and Shaggy, actually, they're huge wrestling fans, whether you like their music or not. They're huge wrestling fans. They're very passionate wrestling fans, too, and they know their shit. But they pretty much brought hardcore to our shores, I would say. After this, you had pretty much ECW going, but King of the Deathmatch, they really put hardcore crazy shit on the map. And rest in peace, Terry Funk. My god, yeah, that he's such an amazing human being. I was so sad when he died, but it was such a great match between Cactus Jack and Terry Funk. Unbelievable. I know Jay and Shaggy actually got sued over this, I think, by Mick Foley for putting this out. And I can see why, you know. But it definitely brought the hardcore style to a lot of people's attention. So, kind of got to give him a bit of a credit for that, you know. But that was a lot of fun, going down a little trip down memory lane with wrestling. There's going to be a shit ton more coming. So, if you're a wrestling fan, I hope you're kind of enjoying this. Kind of switching up a little bit. I'll never stop talking about horror and heavy metal, obviously, but I do like old school pro wrestling, so I figured it'd be kind of cool. But thank you all for watching and subscribing. See you next time.